We now go across to Deepak Jasari, the head of retail and research at HDFC Securities. Hi, Deepak. You know, as 2018 comes to a close, I want to ask you how it is that people like yourselves have had to navigate through the markets with so many skeletons stumbling out of cupboards. You know, look at the number of scams, corporate governance issues that you've had in 2018. It began maybe with Gitanjali Gems and Nirav Modi right in January, going through the slew of auditor resignations, for example, that have taken place, serious corporate governance issues. Last week you had the former SEBI chairman M. Darmodaran sharing a stage with the likes of Uday Kotak and Anand Mahindra talking about this massive problem. It's how difficult has it been?
Good afternoon. Yeah, you're right. The speed at which newer companies come under the radar of corporate governance violations, I think, is unprecedented so far. I think 2018 has seen a number of such companies being investigated or being thrown open to the public. The investing people are also now a bit skeptical. In a country like India, where the equity penetration has not been very large so far, although it has been increasing over the last few years, if more and more such companies are exposed and come out with corporate governance issues, then probably it will put a halt or slow the speed of financialization of savings and investment. It is very unfortunate, and we have seen that such companies are seeing a steep derating in their valuations. Now, promoters at times are wondering as to what wrong has happened, which has led to such steep cut in their valuations. But in the heart of their hearts, if they know that some wrong has been done by them in the past, then probably this is the penalty that they will pay. They are paying now. So in future, I think the promoters, upcoming promoters, the new ones, the old ones, have to be more concerned about such issues. They will now not only have to be clean on corporate governance, but also show that they are very clean. So this is going to be tough in a country like India, but I hope things will change going forward.
Arunya as well from the Mumbai studios joining in. You are talking about metals, which are looking good at this point of time. Is the kind of rally in prices something on expected lines? How are you evaluating the entire situation given what's going on in the China market?
Yeah, we have seen some softening lately in the China markets as far as the demand is concerned as well as the prices are concerned. But we believe that this is a short-term phenomena. The stock prices of steel companies have reacted more than necessary. Given the fact that we have minimum import price and lot of other tariff barriers, the import of steel is not going to be easy. There is going to be protection for the domestic producers, and in such a scenario, the profitability and visibility of growth is likely to be protected. So I think such negative news from China, or even for that matter from the global growth slowdown expectation, should be taken as a reason to bottom fish in such stocks.
So Deepak, you think that the markets may have gotten ahead of themselves when it comes to the metal pack, and I'm guessing that's the case around the world right now for the reaction we're seeing to the 90-day truce. Anything can happen before 90 days, anything can happen post 90 days. What about the oil and gas pack? You're seeing a strong reaction there as well when it comes to crude prices. What does that mean for us back home? Look at an ONGC, IOC, BPCL. You know, from a 40% crash, you've seen crude rebooting, going up towards higher levels. How should one navigate up to this oil and gas pack?
Yeah, within the oil and gas pack, I think the exploration companies should be looked at by investors who are looking only at the dividend yield. So for that matter, whether it is ONGC or Oil India, such stocks should be looked at from those for those investors only. As far as the oil marketing companies are concerned, I think these companies after a very big run up run from 2014 lows to 2017 have now sort of are in a correction mode. Within that correction, you will keep getting trading opportunities. So now whenever these stocks are oversold due to this news, you will get a chance to sort of ride up the upward correction. So that is how the investors should look at as far as OMCs are concerned. They are not buy and perennial hold kind of stocks because of various geopolitical issues, crude price related issues, subsidies and the government hold on the whole sector.
We'll let you go on that note. Thanks much for chatting with us about the stocks that you, rather the sectors that you are preferring at this point of time. At the ET Market Summit,